Sodium is the most common major mineral needed by human bodies. We take sodium mainly from the salt every day, or more specifically in the United States and Canada, the table salt we add to our daily diet. The major food source of sodium is the salt we take every day. The salt sodium chloride contains two major minerals, sodium and chloride. In sodium chloride, the salt sodium ion accounts for 40% and chloride ion accounts for 60% in the weight percentage. Sodium, along with chloride and potassium, is electrolytes minerals. Electrolytes control and regulate fluid balance in and out of human cells. In addition, the electrolytes help to move nutrients into cells and to move water out. Sodium and chloride primarily work outside body cells, whereas potassium works mainly inside the body cells. A high sodium diet draws water into the bloodstream to increase blood volume. Over time, the gradually increased blood volume elevates the blood pressure, causing the heart to work harder. Therefore, overconsuming sodium may be directly linked to increased high blood pressure. On average, the higher the sodium intake, the higher a person's blood pressure. Conversely, reducing sodium intake may help lower blood pressure if it is higher than normal. Normal blood pressure lowers the risk of heart and kidney diseases. As mentioned above, the overconsumption of sodium has side effects on blood pressure. However, an appropriate amount of sodium intake is essential for our bodies to function normally. Because sodium has the following effects on the normal function of the human body, sodium helps regulate fluid balance in and out of body cells. Sodium helps muscles, including the heart, relax. Sodium helps transmit nerve impulses or signals. Sodium helps regulate blood pressure. Although sodium is a major essential mineral needed by our bodies, our sodium needs are relatively small, as long as we do not sweat substantially. The recommended average daily nutrient intake level, the AI, of sodium for most healthy people aged 9 through 50, is 1,500 mg daily. This value accounts for sweat losses. For ages 50 through 70, the AI decreases to 1,300 mg daily. For those over 70 years old, the AI of sodium decreases further to 1,200 mg daily. Sodium keeps the body running normally. People likely consume sodium more than enough. Due to sodium's link to high blood pressure, sodium is a nutrient of public health concern. You may be surprised by the fact that only 1/4 of a teaspoon of table salt contains 1,500 mg of sodium chloride, which is composed of around 600 mg sodium and 900 mg of chloride. We only need slightly less than 3/4 of 1 teaspoon of table salt for most healthy adults. It is advised that reducing daily sodium intake to 1,500 mg is desirable to keep normal blood pressure and lower the blood pressure for people with prehypertension and hypertension. People likely consume sodium more than enough, because many processed foods usually contain sodium. As salt, sodium chloride plays a significant role in baking and food processing. Salt is more than just a seasoning or a flavor enhancer. The following gives you a picture of how the salt, sodium chloride, can be found easily in grocery shopping items. Salt is an essential ingredient in making baked goods, such as bread, crackers, and cakes. Salt is an essential ingredient in baked goods because salt strengthens gluten structure and controls bread dough fermentation. One dot in the bread making process, salt improves bread texture, strengthening gluten structure and making it more stretchable. Salt also reduces the dryness of crackers and other baking goods. 2. Salt inhibits yeast growth. It is, therefore, important for controlling fermentation in bread dough and preventing the development of undesirable wild yeasts. Fermentation changes the chemistry of foods and, as a result, changes the flavor and appearance of foods. 3. Salt can stabilize the beaten egg whites and increase the egg foam's volume. Therefore, salt is easily found in cakes made with whipped egg whites. Another type of food, cheese, also contains salt, sodium chloride. Besides being essential for ripening cheese, salt is required for the quality, shelf life, texture, flavor, and even safety of cheese. In pickled, cured, corned, and some smoked foods, salt is an essential ingredient in the cured foods as a preservative. Canadian sausage, ham, bacon, corned beef, and prosciutto are all made with salt as an ingredient. In addition to being a preservative, sodium chloride, the salt also helps bind the meat together in them. The pickled vegetables such as cucumber, okra, and pepper and other vegetables are all made by pickling vegetables in a high concentration saltwater solution. By reading the nutrition facts table, you can identify how much salt is contained in the foods, and you can carefully control the amount of the foods you eat and therefore control the sodium intake. Reducing sodium intake may help lower blood pressure higher than usual. Normal blood pressure lowers the risk of heart and kidney diseases. Reducing sodium intake to 1,500 mg allows people with hypertension or prehypertension to experience more significant blood pressure reduction. Every incremental decrease in sodium intake likely makes a difference in reducing blood pressure. The body adjusts easily to less salt. When people gradually cut back the amount of salt intake, their desire for salty tastes usually declines accordingly. Over time, the less salt consumed, the less is desired. You can cut back salt and therefore the amount of sodium by shop processed foods with less sodium content. Cut salt in the cooking. You can give your food a flavor burst with spices and herbs, not salt. Eat more fruits and veggies to boost potassium intake. Potassium is rich in various veggies and fruits, and potassium can blunt the effect of sodium on blood pressure. Eat fewer calories. You may also reduce sodium in meals and snacks by eating a few calories. Three other major minerals that may help regulate blood pressure are calcium, potassium, and magnesium. Potassium from fruits, vegetables, milk, and yogurt. By eating more vegetables and fruits, we boost our potassium intake. Potassium helps blunt the effect of sodium on blood pressure. Calcium from dairy foods and some vegetables, magnesium and dark green vegetables, whole grain bread and cereals, nuts and seeds, beans and peas, can help regulate blood pressure. The diet relatively high in calcium, magnesium and potassium with sodium upper limit of 1,500 mg daily may help lower blood pressure even for people within a normal blood pressure range and adults with prehypertension. Healthy foods do not need to be tasted bland just because less salt is used. You can use a variety of spices to enhance the flavor of the dishes without adding more than enough salt. In addition, food can be cooked with natural umami flavor foods such as tomato and mushroom, and some fermented cheese. Cut back on high sodium goods gradually because it takes time for our bodies to unlearn a preference for a salty taste and to learn to appreciate new flavors. When people gradually cut back the amount of salt intake, their desire for salty tastes usually declines accordingly. Over time, the less salt consumed, the less is desired. Reducing sodium intake may help lower blood pressure higher than usual. Normal blood pressure lowers the risk of heart and kidney diseases. Keeping sodium intake as 1,500 mg a day helps maintain normal healthy blood pressure. In addition, reducing sodium intake to 1,500 mg allows people with hypertension or prehypertension to experience more significant blood pressure reduction. Sutasty made this video. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.